Hello, my name is James Lincoln, and this video is to tell you about the changes coming for AP Physics. First, the overall structure, and second, the content-specific changes. In this video, I will also show you some resources available to help you teach for a lab-based physics course, and also how you can address these new changes successfully. All four of the AP Physics exams are now the same length, that is, 3 hours long. It's a big change for the C exams, which were previously 90 minutes each, but not much of a change for AP Physics 1 and 2. Also, all four will be on different days. A very recent and major change is that the first portion of the exam, that is the multiple choice, will be entirely on computer. The second half, free responses, will still be handwritten, but this will probably change in the coming years. The number and types of questions is now standardized across all four exams, and each exam consists of 40 multiple choice questions and 4 free response questions. Each half of the exam is weighted equally at 50% of the overall grade. The multiple choice section will be 80 minutes long, and the free response section will be 100 minutes long. All the multiple choice questions will have 4 choices, and there's no penalty for guessing. Further, we will no longer be seeing these pick 2 style of questions from AP 1 and 2, and you will no longer be asked to write a clear, coherent paragraph. The types of free response questions are now standardized, and here's a chart that summarizes the 4 question types and what to expect, including the order of the questions. Number 1, mathematical routines, 10 points. Number 2, translating between representations, 12 points. Number 3, experimental design and analysis, 10 points. Number 4, qualitative and quantitative translation, 8 points. Now we will talk about the exam content-specific changes. AP Physics 1 is getting pretty much the fluids unit transferred directly from the old AP Physics 2. This fluids unit focuses on the 4 main topics of ideal fluids: the relationship between force and pressure, the relationship between pressure and depth, the buoyant force, and Bernoulli's equation, as well as the continuity equation. Since AP Physics 1 will be covering only ideal fluids, meaning no viscosity and the density is constant, there is no testing on the gas laws and the atomic molecular nature of matter, and this is true, it's not part of the curriculum. That includes Boyle's law and the compressibility of gases, but you may wish to include these topics in your instruction. AP Physics 1 is also gaining a few rotational dynamics specific topics, such as the parallel axis theorem, as well as a qualitative treatment of slipping while rotating or rolling. AP Physics 2 will now include waves and sound, including standing waves, and all the circuits curriculum that was previously part of the old AP Physics 1. Additionally, a qualitative treatment of RC circuits is included, as well as specific heat. Some deleted topics include relativity and quantum probability graphs, but equals MC squared problems are still included, as well as de Broglie waves, Compton scattering, and an expansion of the details of the black body spectrum. Radioactivity and half-life problems are also on the exam. Regarding the AP Physics C exams, there's very little content change. The changes are mostly in the length of the exams and the number and restructuring of the questions. However, on the C mechanics exam, the required content now specifically includes gravity forces within a planet, but that had previously been tested in 1999, for example, and also the physical pendulum, which in the same way we already saw on the 2009 exam. Also, resistive forces such as air resistance and damped harmonic motion are now included, but as you probably know, these topics were already tested for in many previous AP Physics C tests. On the electricity and magnetism exam, the required content now specifically includes LC circuits, meaning that they resonate, but not LRC circuits, meaning that the circuits are ideal and there's no resistance. Also note that the RC and LR circuits, that is resistor capacitor or inductor resistor, are still on the exam with their content unchanged. The AP program has recently released the new versions of the equation sheets, which I link below. Here, we can see some of the changes and additions to the AP Physics 1 curriculum. Also, the additions to the AP Physics 2 equations are evident. AP Physics C remains largely unchanged, as you might expect. There's only a few equations on the list that are new. One big change, however, is that the electricity and magnetism equation sheet is now on its own separate page. Thank you for watching this video, and I wish you the best.